state of emergency. You need to understand that. You need to understand that tonight is just about, not about us just coming and talking to you. You're in a state of emergency. Because back in the 60s when we went to school and got educated and we brought it home. We're not bringing it home no more. When we go home for Thanksgiving, we're not teaching our cousin to cut off BET. As a matter of fact, we're listening to BET with them. And we're not saying that hip-hop music in itself is wrong, but we're saying because they're not, they don't have a father in their lives, hip-hop has become their daddy. And so we're not telling them at a young age, study Shakespeare. We're not telling them at a young age that they need to know the 8 parts of speech. We're not telling them that when you get to college, you're going to need math.
It's not even that, you know, this work is hard. It's not that you can't do it. It's for real, man. I didn't have a mindset coming into college. When I came in, I'm going to be real with you, I hadn't seen so many girls in all my life. You know, I stayed on the 5th floor in a co-ed dorm with 5 floors up and 5 floors down. I couldn't believe it, right? And so I didn't have the mindset, and I vowed right then never to let that same thing happen to any young freshman that I come in contact with.
Du Bois said it is the talented 10th. It is the best of our rates who will save the contaminated of our rates. The whole black community is dependent upon the students who go to college. If we can't count on those of us who are getting educated, who can we count on? The drug dealers? Are they going to teach them? The pimps? Are they going to teach them? It is the responsibility of those of us who are privileged.
And so long story short, I met Eric Thomas. We started the Advantage program. Like he said, man, we get 150, 200 kids now, man. Students coming in. They can ask me about 1825, tutor them with 1825. We set up a program where we have upperclassmen help them, people who've been through these classes. My man passed chemistry with a 4.0. It's no reason why you pass chemistry with a 4.0. You struggling in chemistry right now. Both of y'all minorities on this campus, and you have no idea who he is because there's no social network set up for the two of y'all to link up and do y'all thing. I said, that's ridiculous.
Don't fool yourself because of your little SAT scores. There were blacks who were smarter than us who couldn't go to college because it was illegal, who couldn't get an education. So don't fool yourself because you're here and you think you all of that. You are here because of the backs of people like the Dr. Martin Luther King, who had a doctorate degree, who did not have to get involved in the struggle, who was in the middle class, who lost his wife and his children for the struggle. He had a PhD. He had a good job as a minister. He was making good money, but he gave it all up so that we could go to school one day.
We had a young lady, you know, she lost her mom. We had a young man who's the president of my organization who lost his mother and his father in the last year. And if it wasn't for his brothers and people like myself and Eric Thomas, he'd have been out of this university. He'd have been long gone. He'd been home because that's the easy thing to do when things pile on. You don't have that support system, so you out of there. But because he had that support system telling him, you can do it, bro. We got you. We your family. We got you. You need help financially, whatever you need, we got it.
I say this all the time. Coretta, I mean, what did she have to go through? She lost Dr. Martin Luther King. Let me tell you something. When you lose Dr. Martin Luther King, who else you going to get married to? Like, who's the runner-up bachelor? So once your husband died, you're going to be by yourself for the rest of your life. There is no, you're not going to hook up with another Dr. Martin Luther King. Their children, the children grew up without their father. He did not have to die in the struggle, but he made a conscious decision that it's a state of emergency, and if I want a Barack to ever have a chance, I've got to sacrifice my life now.
Seeing stuff like that is really why we do the Advantage program. Really why I'm encouraging you guys to do the Advantage program. We have a lot of students that fall through the cracks every year. Michigan State is only graduating 3 out of 10 black males right now. It's an emergency, right? And we all know the facts. There's more black men in prison than it is in college. We all know that. And so since I'm not in the prison system, and I am in the college system, if I can get more of y'all to stay in, then we can start evening them numbers out.
You're a junior. It's your responsibility to take a freshman under your wing, to take a sophomore under your wing, and not to haze them. Not to humiliate them. That's not what it's about. That's not what we're here for. Not to make them go and do your laundry. You grown, do your own laundry. Not to make them fill up your car with gas. That's not what Martin did. That's not what Malcolm did. As a matter of fact, as the leader, I am to serve. So I need to wash your clothes if you're a freshman. I need to buy you food if you're a freshman, if you're a sophomore. I need to help you. And so it's important that we gather these values and then we go back to our communities and we instill these values into our young people. I gotta show you this, this is deep. I gotta show you this quickly. Over 70% of African American males in the juvenile systems were raised in homes without their fathers. And we're not asking you to be a father. What we are asking you to do is, because you're becoming educated, we're asking you to bring about change. Because that's what education is about, change, access, power. We don't get an education just to make money. Money is not enough. You need to be at the tables. At Michigan State, I told the assistant provost, I'm not interested in just a raise. I need to sit at the tables where the decisions are made. I need jobs so I can give my students internships and jobs when they graduate. I need scholarships so I can give my students scholarships. I need a budget so when they don't have money for books, I can give them money for books. I need access. I need to help make decisions. I need to make their lives and their jobs on this campus easier. I need to connect them to the right resources. I need to know the professors. We need to eat together. I need you to tell me what's going on in your class, how my students can prepare themselves to become doctors and lawyers. I need more money. For what? More stuff? I need access. I'm saying to you, if the university never tells you to establish anything, it's your responsibility to get together and put a program together that's creative, so that when these students come in, they have a place to go, where they can learn how to write if they don't know how to write. We're actually looking at their papers saying, give us the papers. We know you don't want to go to your professor. Give it to us. We're going to show you how to write. Right? We bring other students in who know, there's some student who's good in chemistry, some who's good in math, some who's good in writing. And we say, look, we need your resources. We need you to help one another to get out. Because just because you're good in English doesn't mean you're good in math. And so you guys are going to help each other out. And so listen to me. I'll leave you before 1825 comes on. This is not about a program. This is about creating history. This is about creating history. Yes, we can. We're not just talking about Barack. Yes, we can right here at IU. Yes, we can. Yes, we can take the numbers up. Yes, we can bring retention up. We can bring persistency up. Yes, we can bring the graduation rate up. We got it. And now we've got to get past what Dubois calls just that social group, that social entertainment, and use the power that we have to make a change. At IU, I believe you guys can do it. Thank you.